Okay, good morning to all. Today we are going to discuss about the virtual memory. So, what do you mean that virtual memory? First, we'll discuss. A virtual memory is a storage allocation scheme in which secondary memory can be addressed as thought if it were part of the main memory, and the addresses a program may use to reference memory are distinguished from the address the memory system uses. They identify physical storage sites, and program-generated addresses are translated automatically to the corresponding machine address. That means the virtual memory is nothing. It is not actual memory. That means the primary memory. Right? And the portion of some primary memory acts as a secondary memory. The portion of the secondary memory acts as a primary memory, and that is known as the virtual memory. It is not actual the primary memory, but behaves like the virtual memory, and it is the part of the secondary memory. Or when the one part of the secondary memory acts as a primary memory, then it is known as the virtual memory concept. So, you can clarify this virtual memory concept through two component: memory paging and memory segmentation. So, first come to the memory paging. Paging is a memory management scheme that eliminates the need for contiguous allocation of physical memory, and this scheme permits the physical address space of a process to be non-contiguous memory allocation. So, there is two type of contiguous memory allocation. One is your contiguous memory allocation, another non-contiguous memory allocation. Contiguous memory allocation is that where all the data is stored in the continuous manner, but in the non-contiguous allocation, these all are the stored in the reference form or in the non-contiguous form. The mapping from virtual physical address is done by the memory management unit MMU, which is a hardware device, and this mapping is known as paging technique. The physical address space is conceptually divided into a number of fixed size blocks called frames, and the logical address space is also splitted into fixed size blocks called pages, and page size equal to frame size. Okay, that is the memory paging. Addresses generated by CPU is divided into page number. Address generated by CPU or processor divided into page number P. The number of bits required to represent the page in logical address space or page number. Page offset, number of bits required to represent a particular word in a page, or page size of logical address space, or word number of page or page offset. Physical address is divided into frame number, the number of bits required to represent the frame of physical address space or frame number. Frame offset small d, number of bits required to represent particular word in a frame, or frame size of physical address space or word number of frame or frame offset. Right. So, these are the page number and page offset generated by CPU, and is the frame number and the frame offset generated by the main memory or the physical address divided into it. Next, what are the advantages? The advantages of paging are: it allows to store parts of a single process in a non-contiguous fashion, and it solves the problem of external fragmentation. Right. So, disadvantages. Now, the disadvantage of paging are: it suffers from internal fragmentation, and there is an overhead of maintaining a page table for each process. The time taken to fetch the instruction increases, since now two memory access are the required. So, these are the disadvantages. Next, come to the memory segmentation. In operating system, segmentation is a memory management technique in which the memory is divided into the variable size parts. Each part is also known as a segment which can be allocated to a process. So, the details about each segment are stored in a table called a segment table, and segment table is stored in one or many of the segments. Segments tables contains mainly two information about segment. One is your base, another is your limit. Now here, what is base? It is the base address of the segment, and limit is the length of the segment. So what are the advantages? Now the advantages of segmentation are, it allows to divide the program into modules, which provides better visualization. Segment table consumes less space as compared to page table in paging. It solves the problem of internal fragmentation. Next is your disadvantages. The disadvantages of segmentation are, there is an overhead of maintaining a segment table for each process. The time taken to phase the instruction increases, since now two memory accesses are required. Segments of unequal size are not suited for swapping. It suffers from external fragmentation as the free space gets broken down into smaller pieces with the processes being loaded and removed from the memory. That means it suffers from external fragmentation as the free space gets broken down into smaller pieces with the processor being loaded and removed from the main memory. And this is the difference between paging and segmentation. The first is your, what do you mean the paging or the segmentation? Paging is your non-contiguous memory allocation, while segmentation also the non-contiguous memory allocation. Paging divides programs into fixed size space. Segmentation divides program into variable size segments. And in case of paging, operating system is responsible, but in case segmentation, compiler is responsible. Next, paging is faster than segmentation, where segmentation is closer to the user. It suffers from the internal fragmentation, and it also suffers from external fragmentation. There is no external fragmentation, there is no external fragmentation. Logical address is divided into page number and page offset. A logical address is divided into segment number and segment offset. In case of paging, page table is used to maintain the page information, while segment table maintains the segment information. Page table entry has the frame number and some flag bits to represent details about the pages. Segment table entry has the base address of the segment and the some protection bits for the segment. So these are the difference between the paging and the segmentation. So this is all about your chapter number 4. And from next class onwards, we are going to discuss about chapter number 5. So thank you to all. Thank you.